on the inside of the turn, it's shaped like a dome. The peak or the highest point of that is known as the apex of the corner. That's kind of the point you want to aim for when you turn into the corner, okay? So basically, you want to be near that white line. You have to keep in mind the cart's wider in the back than the front. So if you're all over the white line, your rear tire is going to be in the grass, okay? So on that instance, you're on the inside of the corner, so outside, inside. Once you get to the apex, you're going to accelerate out of the corner and let the car gravitate to the far opposite edge of the track. Outside, inside, outside. It's the straightest, smoothest path to the corner. Allow you to create the most amount of speed and have the most amount of traction. If you get to the apex and you're 3 to 4 feet away from the white line, you're in what's known as the marbles. The marbles is dust, dirt, sand, and pieces of old tire. The car's not going to break as well out there. It's not going to steer as well out there, okay? So it'll be on the racing line. I just described to have the best results and the most amount of traction to your cart, all right? If at any point you feel like you're losing control of the cart, okay? Back up my stuff. I got ahead of myself. Some other basic driving tips, okay? Braking in a straight line, okay? If you have the wheel turn and you slam on the brakes, you don't want to set the cart to a little bit of a spin, okay? You want to do all your braking with the wheel straight. So wheel straight, off gas, brake, off brake, and then turn into the corner, okay? On the inside of most of the corners are these concrete curbs. You can see around the second turn there, it's like it's very shallow. That one you can touch a little bit. Some of the other curbs are very steep, okay? If you hit them with your car, you don't want to send the car into a little bit of a spin, okay? So you want to try to avoid the curbs as much as possible to avoid losing control of the cart and spinning out, okay? If at any point you feel like you're losing control of the cart, like you're spinning, off the gas and hold your foot on the brake, until you come to a complete stop, okay? You can look both ways to see if it's safe to proceed. If it is, then go ahead and do so, okay? If you're facing the wrong way, the key to getting the car turned around, if you just turn the wheel all the way and hit the gas, you're not going to go anywhere. What you have to do is go straight for a little bit, get the car rolling. You go straight for like a foot, now the car's starting to roll, then turn the wheel and hit the gas, and you should be able to turn around much easier, okay? If you do that stop your spot, do not get out of your cart, okay? Last thing I want is when you guys get hit by someone else, one of us will come out and get you, okay? Just stay in your cart until we come out and rescue you. If you're really stuck, like if you're beached, so what that is that something's holding the middle of the cart up and the rear tires aren't on the ground, do not hold the gas for like a minute at full RPM. It's very, very bad for the engines, okay? So I doubt very many of you enjoyed it by jumping your road cars. Put it in neutral and just slam the gas for 30 seconds. Same thing here, okay? If you're stuck, you can try to get going. So you can hold the gas all the way and the engine's really making a lot of noise. Just go like, one, two, three. If you're not going anywhere, just take your foot off the gas and wait. If you're stuck, and you're not going to get out, okay? So just take it easy and we will come out and get you in that instance, all right? We're going to end off on passing or overtaking, okay? For all your passing, you go on the inside. The right-hand turn, pass on the right. Left-hand turn, pass on the left. Reason being that going on the outside is A, a longer distance, and B, you have to go through the marbles. We're going to have a lot less traction, okay? If someone's going really, really slow, like less than half your speed, and you think it's safer to go on the outside, by all means do so. But if someone's going the same speed as you, you're not really going to outsmart them going around the outside, okay? You're either going to have to back out of it or lose control trying to make it happen, okay? What I don't want to see out there is overly aggressive defensive driving. For instance, if someone is on the inside of you, you start turning into them, you get on the back out of the pass, that's straight to a black flag, okay? If you're on the inside of someone, and you're trying to push them off the track, straight to a black flag, okay? If you are looking behind you and swerving to keep someone behind you, is literally the most ridiculously unsafe thing to do in a car, okay? And karting things happen in an instant. If you're looking behind you and someone spins in front of you, you're going to label them full tilt, okay? If someone's behind you or beside you, you're going to hear the sound of their engine, okay? You can have a quick look, like this, look, and then back, okay? You don't want to be looking away from the front for too much longer, right? Most of these things I just described are going to either A, end in a crash, or B, end in the black flagging, okay? There's absolutely no point to overly aggressive defensive driving. If someone gets beside you, give them enough room, let them get by, and then tuck back in behind them. You can try to pass them back the next turn or the turn after that. If they're quicker than you, you can try to follow them to see what they're doing and maybe increase increase your own lap time, or decrease your own lap time to love, okay? There's absolutely no benefit to all-wheel drive driving, but just keep it clean out there and safe out there, and everyone's going to have a very good time, all right? Does anybody have any questions? All right, cool. I'm going to grab the group list right here, and we'll start off with the group one. If I call your name, do up your suit, and we're going to jump in this middle row of carts here, okay? Yes, sir. Motor off, and then press the top right button. So once the motor's off, you should have pressed it firmly, and once, then let go, and you just pop your pads and come up.
Can't check it while...
No, it's going to flash when you drive by the start finish line, but don't be looking at your steering wheel when you're about to hit the corner. It's like this, have a quick look, then back up. Alright, guys? Any more questions? Super! We're going to do group one. Shang, Jihin, Leo, Richard, Scott, KK, Jesse, and Ling. So you guys will be in the middle row first, okay? Do up your suits, put your helmet on, okay? So group two, just so you know, will be Kyle, Elan, Yunlun, Justin, Jackson, Clarence, Russell, Annan, Alan, and Asvani, Azini. All right, guys, so did I miss anybody's name? Everyone's accounted for, super. Group one, helmets on, suits on, and you get in the middle row of carts. Group two, you guys can wait behind the fence. Until group one is done or about to be done, I'll call you guys next, all right?
Even the Democrat.
Well, that was, I guess it was the what we had left from the drive drive earlier.
Yes, the helmets are numbered from 1 to 12. 1 is small, 12 is extra large. The ones that are not numbered are generally extra, extra large and really big ones, okay? Cool. Alright, guys, so grab the suitable helmet and hop into a cart. No, it's perfect. You got your own but, alright, group one, guys, hop in. We just start practice.
Thank you.
21. 21 is the one that I know.